Hi, in this video I am going to have a look at the game Gems of War. Sorry. You fight, there are a lot of levels, and you each time fight with your team against an enemy team, normally a computer opposition, but I believe there's also a player versus player mode. You can compose your team of characters, can be troops, can be weapons. At this moment I don't have any other choices than my baby dragon and my sword of heroes, so that's what I'm sticking to. But later, as you progress through the game, you will get more and more, and you can improve these weapons and characters in various ways as well. Let's go to the battle. We can talk a bit more. So each battle is a match three game, and that's how I came to look at this game. I thought this was just another match three puzzle game, but it's actually not a puzzle game at all. Here it's all about doing damage to your opposition. They, well, each myself and the opposition have some armor 3 and life 6 and some attack value. So these are relatively weak, the opposition, with 1 armor, 3 life, and 2 attack value. And we see these round ones here. This corresponds to the mana you need to charge this. And once it is fully charged, you can use its ability to do damage to the opponent. Each character has its own unique ability that it casts. And sometimes that is, or often there is some direct damage involved, but it could also be other things. So in this case, if I make a match of blue gems here, it will get mana here. For red, it will get mana there. And my opposition needs a green for both. If you do a match of three, you simply get 3 of that mana, or sometimes you get a mana surge and then you get double the mana. If you do a match of 4, you get 4 mana, but also the nice thing is you have another turn, because this is a turn based, normally I start, I make one move, which can be either doing a swapping a gem to make a match, or can be casting the ability of one of my characters. Long story. And this is quite a complicated game, but it is quite nice if you like this combination of role-playing game elements where you improve your characters via all kind of different ways, and the match 3 game as at its core. So I'm going to start with doing this match of 4. I get an extra turn, and oh, something was removed there as well, so I have a total of 7 out of the required 8 mana that I need. I don't see any match of 4, so I'm going to do another match of 3, so that I'm sure to have my mana fully charged. Now you see there is this blue border around this, and the mana is removed, the mana requirement, so it means we can cast it. It deals 2 damage to a random enemy and transforms into a random dragon. The 2 damage is quite small, or very small, but to transform into a random dragon, that is quite quite nice. Now we have a very deal 4 damage to all enemies. That is definitely a very interesting skill. Explode a column, not really sure whether that is that useful, but that is a nice little extra thing, I would say. Okay, so and here you also have sometimes different manas are accepted, green and brown in this case, but it can, I've also seen it up to 3, and maybe there are even characters that have more, allow more different kind of mana. And if you have different characters will require the same mana. The mana will always go first to the one on top, unless that one is fully filled, then it will go to the second one. So that is something to keep in mind. You cannot select where you want your mana to go. Really like brown and green, but I don't see any. Let's do this one. We can cast this one. 3 damage to the first enemy. So then at first it is deducted from the armor and then from the life. I'm doing something that I shouldn't do. I'm taking this 3 mana, but now I allowed him to make a match of 3 skulls. And if you do a match of 3 skulls, you directly do damage to your opponent. So that is something you should prevent. But I didn't prevent that. I did it anyway. Sometimes it happens by coincidence, like I removed some things and then suddenly I had a match 3 of the... And now this is fully charged again. Just wanted to use this skill for fun, but totally unnecessary now because there is only... select a column to remove... Well, doesn't really matter now, remove that one. Oh, it's 3 columns. It already moved, but that was quite easy. In the beginning, you're really you as a player level up. I think this is the or is this? It is quite complicated. Magic mastery. At this moment, I don't really have a current focus on a current type of mana yet. But if you say, okay, I'm only going to play with green and brown, and that's dependent on the monsters that you are, for example, then it could be good to focus on those the most with choosing this mastery each time you level up. Because this mastery increases the chance that you have a mana surge, which means you get extra mana for making matches. So if that, if you're always playing with, like the example I gave, green and brown characters, then focus on those masteries to increase those so that you have a higher chance of getting the mana surge for those. Not saying that I will do that, but I have selected that one anyway. Get an extra weapon. And we can do another level. We now have a more powerful weapon. The priest's hammer. And for the rest, there is still nothing to do. What else there can be? But yeah, the only troop I have is still the baby dragon. But now we have this priest's weapon. Supposedly that's better, that's what it tries to tell me. Let's see, can we already... There are various ways we can ascend it. We can upgrade the level. For that we need ingredients. We will get... maybe we will get through that later. But the idea is, as you play more, you progress, you can make your, you can get better, better characters, but you can also make your characters stronger, because there are, there are going to be a lot of tough challenges ahead. So this game definitely will keep you occupied for a very long time. Now I have to do red and brown. I'm first going to do purple because I can. That was some free. Some free matches. I went for purple, but I did some other things as well. And I went for the purple because it was a match of four, which allowed me an extra turn. It's always good to grab those. I'm going to do that for light splash damage to the first enemy. That is already nice. Now, let's start matching again. I think I'm just going to keep playing for that first one if I have a chance. If I can't do it, anything red? No. No. Take that four. I didn't notice that before, but luckily the game pointed it out to me. He doesn't want brown, but he takes my brown. Yes. So that's also a thing. If you cannot match something yourself, you can choose to take something like, in this case, blue and green, because I know that my opponent likes those. Do the direct damage instead of using the hammer, because if I would do the direct damage, if I would do my hammer, then he would use the direct damage. And now I can still use the hammer and victory. Level up again. But you can each time only make certain choices, so you cannot really have too much focus, but it helps you a bit with focus. Now I'm not going to think too much about that. We have another weapon. And the goblins will join us. Now the main, maybe this is a time to, can I? Seems I'm still a bit stuck there. Let's look at that later, because I wanted to walk through the menu. Hopefully that opens up soon to show a bit of other sides of the game. I'm not sure, because I also have a new weapon, you could argue. And if I get something new, in this case I'm not sure. Scatter damage, it's often nicer. Scatter damage, it randomly does that for the opponents. It's often nicer to have some focus, so, but that's always to the first enemy, but then at least you focus all your damage on that one. And maybe I'm going to stay with the priest's hammer for now. Well, let's start with the direct damage. Boom, that was already one opposition, so the opposition is not very impressive at all. Oh, it's also double mana. And this level is already done. Okay. Now I can have a look at maybe this giant's mace. It requires more mana, but it deals more splash damage, and I can select the enemy. So that's more interesting for me. Troops, nothing new here, so let's I clicked one time back too often. To battle. Let's see. I like the brown ones. Not seeing anything more interesting. I like the direct damage, of course. Red or green, don't see either. It's surprising he's not going for blue, so at this level the computer opposition is still not so impressive. Boom. So these early levels are very, very simple, and this game is already getting quite This video is already getting quite long. Ah, okay, nice. Now we can walk through this menu a bit to see the options. This trenching board, not that interesting. Campaign need to be a lot further. Purchase something. Rewards. For ads, global chat, no. So there is a player versus player mode, but for that you need to be level 10, so that it cannot show either. There are certain other games you can do besides the main mission, but these, I've tried these and they are already very challenging. So I think you should build up your characters a bit more via this Broken Spire storyline, and maybe even doing others after you have done that before you get into these other games. So you can join a guild. Haven't seen I don't know yet whether I mean it's good to do it, but I haven't seen that many benefits yet, let's put it like that. You can get some chests and keys, but I don't for that you need those in-game credits, and probably you can earn them, but maybe this is also a way to get better stuff for spenders. So the troops that I currently have, you can compose your teams, you can have multiple teams once you have higher levels, and you can also here work on upgrading and improving your cards. So that is what we can do, I guess. Not much. So you can train the XP level of your characters. Let's just do it now. So you saw that certain aspects of the character increase a bit, which is nice. But you, and you can gather these things by just keep playing the levels and winning them. So the idea is that you eventually get better and better cards. It's a bit, for me at this moment, still a bit difficult to advise, saying, okay, you know, normally in these type of games, it's not so good to use all your resources to improve the characters you get early on. Might be better to play a bit more until you get better characters and focus on improving those. But yeah, it's always a bit of a trade-off, because as you get further into the game, you're likely to get better troops again. So that is quite difficult. That makes it also challenging. There will be a very large amount of characters that you can use, so that you can compose your own team, and you also encounter other players with completely different teams. Okay, it's a bit of a long video. I'm not sure whether it has all been very coherent, but I do like these kind of games a lot. I say these kind of games, but I haven't actually seen, supposedly there are more out there, but I haven't seen a match 3 RPG game. I do find it quite interesting, although the puzzle game is not that is not too big a part, I would say. Even though you play it again and again, it doesn't seem very challenging, but it's more about putting in the time and improving your characters, playing around with different teams, and making some team that can get you far in this game. So that's quite nice. I give it 9 out of 10 stars. If you like this kind of game, I think you're going to really like this this title. If you have any comments or any questions, that is much appreciated, and thanks for watching.